Hi viewers, welcome to Botany Point. This video is about mechanism of stomatal transpiration. So let's start the video. So here some points about the mechanism of stomatal transpiration. Before we start this point, first we just know about some basic things. That is here. Come to the stoma. So stoma are mostly found in our, in case of our lower epidermis of leaf. Okay, the more percentage of stoma are found in lower epidermis. Okay, and these stoma are closed or not closed, open. The stoma are open during daytime. So due to opening of stomata, two beneficiary things are happen, or two functional things are happen, that is our photosynthesis and second one is transpiration. So what happen in case of photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is the process of food synthesis. Here the food synthesis occur. And in case of transpiration, the release of excess amount of water in the form of water vapor. Okay. So where it release out, which medium? That is stoma. Okay. And the water vapor release out from the leaves and aerial part of the plants. Then next, about the photosynthesis here, what happened? In case of photosynthesis, during synthesis of food, it need what? CO2. Due to opening of stomata, the CO2 easily enters to the plant body. Okay, stoma open, so CO2 enters. And due to stoma open, also water in the form of vapor, that is release out. Okay, water vapor release out. So stoma here work as or source two functions. Clear? Okay. Then next come about the ranges. The number of stoma ranges about 1000 to 10,000 per centimeter square in the cell. Okay, the next types of leaf cells. Here some special types of cells are found in the leaf, that is called mesophyll cell. This word comes during while I starting to discuss about the mechanism of stomatal transpiration. This word must come, that is mesophyll cell. So mesophyll cells are mainly found in our leaf. Remember this one. Then come to our cell space. Okay, cell space. So cell space mainly two types. One is intercellular spaces and intracellular spaces. Okay, so come to here intercellular spaces. Here in case of intercellular spaces, the space between the two cell, okay, here the space between the two cell, and in case of intra, here what happened? Inside the space between the cell. Got it? So what happened in these spaces? Solvent are passes, which is mostly water, are passes here. So here the water which passes through this process is mainly two process, both in intercellular spaces and also intracellular spaces. Remember. Okay, Here intercellular spaces, the solvent passes through wall of the cells and here inside the cell to cell. Okay, remember intercellular spaces. Then comes to next, water vapor. Why the water are released out from the plant body through stomata in the form of water vapor? This is the one most important question. Water vapor form. Why water release out in the leaves or stoma in the form of water vapor form? Why? So these are two important terms, that is osmotic pressure and DPD pressure. DPD, that is diffusion pressure deficit. Okay, through these pressures the water is moving or just released out in the form of water vapor, remember. Okay, then come to about osmosis and imbibition. First is our osmosis. So in case of osmosis, what happens? The solvent is always moving or moves from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. Okay, remember here what happened, the movement of solvent occur in higher concentration to lower concentration. What happened in case of imbibition? Imbibition, before you know about the imbibition, we should know about what? Absorption. So absorption mainly two type. This is absorption and one is adsorption. Okay, suppose you just take here one duster. Okay, just take here one duster. Okay, you know the duster. Suppose the upper part of duster is made up of foam or cotton. Cotton or foam. Okay, so what happen if I just pour some drop of water? Okay, pour some drop of water or just about one glass or half cup of water in this duster. Then what happens? The water absorbed by the cotton part. Why cotton part? Because this is the soft part and here the duster, the lower part is made up of what? Wooden part. Okay, the down part is wooden part and upper part is cotton part. So when I pour the water inside the on the duster, what happened? The cotton part absorb the water, but the wooden part doesn't what? Absorb the water. Okay. So here what happened? The absorption of water occurred in the surface area of the what? Upper surface area of the duster. Okay. Likewise, in case of cell, here also if you when it contact the solvent, some cases the water just absorbed by its cell wall. Okay, water absorb only on the part of the cell wall. Okay, in such type of absorption is called adsorption. Okay, if the water absorbed by the total of the cell, okay, all total of the cell, then it called as absorption. Remember, so what happened in case of imbibition? The water imbibition is the case where the absorption of water occur only surface area. So directly we call imbibition is a adsorption phenomenon. Okay, remember you got it? What is absorption and adsorption? So imbibition is the adsorption phenomenon. What happen in case of imbibition? During the absorption of cell occur only the surface region, the upper region, not the total of the cell. So here the water just travel. Okay, when the water travel in the form of water vapor, how it travel? In two ways, that is through imbibition and also through osmosis. Okay, when it travels water travels through osmosis, that means it related to the intracellular spaces, and when the water travel through the imbibition, it related to the intercellular spaces. If osmosis, then intracellular spaces. If imbibition, then intercellular spaces. Okay, and in intercellular means upper is just between the two cells. The solvent travel between the two cells. That means the cell wall here, the cell wall is absorbed. Only the cell wall part is absorbed by the what cell. But here, in case of intracellular means, the water is moves through cell to cell. That means total cell are absorbed. Then it, when it full by water, suppose here one cell is absorbed water or solvent, then here what happened, the concentration is higher. So now where it moves to the lower concentration, here the solvent concentration is higher. The nearest cell where the solvent concentration is low is automatically travel to here. Okay, so this process is called our osmosis. Clear about osmosis and imbibition. Okay, got it? Now come to this point, all of the point here. These are the most fundamental things to easily understand about the mechanism of the stomata transportation. Then come to the point one by one. Here what happened? See, osmotic diffusion of water in the leaf from xylem to intercellular spaces above the stomata through the mesophyll cell. So here what happened, due to osmosis or the osmotic diffusion of the water, the leaf of the xylem to intercellular spaces above the stomata through the mesophyll cells. Okay, then what happened also, opening and closing of stomata, that is stomata movement also done. Okay, the next, simple diffusion of water vapor from intercellular spaces to other atmosphere through stomata. Then next point, inside the leaf the mesophyll cells are in contact obviously with xylem and on the other hand with intercellular spaces above the stomata. When mesophyll cells draw water from the xylem, they become turgid and their diffusion pressure deficit DPD and osmotic pressure decreases, with the result that they release water in the form of water vapor, okay, or the vapor in intercellular spaces close to the stomata by osmotic diffusion. Now OPD and DPD of mesophyll cells become higher and hence they draw water from xylem to osmotic diffusion. Okay, one important term, where the water are comes. Obviously, wait. The water, where the water are comes? From the soil. Soil contain the water and it absorbed by the root, and the root is just transferred, or the water transferred from the root to stem to leaves through xylem. Remember, okay? So the xylem, water transferred from the root to where? Leaves. And leaves what? Leaves have what? Stoma. From the stoma to pour the water. Release out. Excess water are released out in the form of water vapor. Clear? So here a diagram. Here what happened? xylems, through xylems water travel and it reach to the mesophyll cell. Okay, the leaves contain the mesophyll cell. Through the xylem, now the water reaches to the mesophyll cells of the leaf. Okay, now how it reaches to mesophyll cells? That is in two form. That is to when mesophyll cells, then to it moves to the where? This spaces. Movement to vibration substomatal spaces. Then come to the small substomatal region. Or mesophyll cell to mesophyll cell, this travel through two processes. One is intercellular spaces and second one is intracellular spaces. If it is intercellular spaces, then the water travels in the process of imbibition. Remember, if it is intercellular spaces, then imbibition occurs. And second process also happen here, through where water transfer in the form of water vapor, that is through what? Intracellular spaces. And if it's intracellular spaces, then osmosis occur. But in this case, what happened? Most of the water vapor travels along the cell wall. Okay. So when cell wall means here intercellular spaces, that is okay, the water travels to intercellular spaces, that means directly imbibition occur. So most of the water travels along the cell wall by imbibition. Clear? Okay. Then it finally reach to the what? This intercellular spaces, and here above the stomata, that is substomata region also there, substomata spaces, then it comes to the stoma and finally water remove. Okay, so the remove two processes are helpful, that is osmotic pressure and DPD, diffusion pressure deficit. Okay, so this is part one video about mechanism of stomatal transpiration. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, so please hit the like button, try to share more and more. And don't forget to subscribe Botany Point. Thank you so much.